Thank you very much. Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here and to address what would be the future for radiation oncology. I have to say that I try to answer to this question in with three main tables. One is the destiny, the old destiny, and the second is future and knowledge, and then future and technology. Why destiny? Because many times radiation oncologists were approached and say, you have a very clear end of your future. And the first German paper that was in the Red Journal, the Journal of the American Society of Radiation Oncology at the beginning of this millennium, stated that in 2095, tulin accelerator will be positioned again the MoMA, because no way, already the cancer will be solved, and anyway radiotherapy will be any longer there. 2070, ASTRO will dissolve. And that's how it happens. Go back in the retrochrono program. There were some recombination technology between 50 and 60, and then there were much more gene understanding and manipulation between 30 and 40. And then we arrive to our age, more control of radiotherapy appropriateness and side effect, and finally, suicide gene 2 years ago, and tailored prescription as gene profile 7 years ago. So it seems that there is a gap. And it happens so many times that there is just another way to say the destiny of radiotherapy. Pierre Scalier, chair of Leuven Radiation Oncology Department, want to have an academic career. At that time, in the 80s, it was said, no, you have not the right profile, you have to go to radiotherapy. And he said, why? What I did so wrong to go radiotherapy? Because there was no appealing for radiotherapy, because there were new development behind the corner, and at the end, we are still doing radiotherapy. So the final destiny, of course, will be cure the cancer, and radiotherapy will end up. And that is in our knowledge. But what will happen in between? We saw that we have some delay, and one major challenge that radiotherapy will have in front of us is to deal with knowledge. 2-3 months ago, there was in Rome a very interesting conference between theologists, philosophers, and IT people. The chair of the Italian Institute of Technology addressed the issue that artificial intelligence would be for sure the dream to have robots with a very similar human behavior. But what is the major difficulty? It was already mentioned before, that we have to deal with natural stupidity. And what is natural stupidity? It's what we like. I like a lot to be creative, sometimes to be not rational, because this is something that is not so, that creates some identity in ourselves, in our human history. And what means that, what is the challenge? You know, big computers, they start to understand, to learn, to make reasonings. And that could offer a real impact in the clinical decision matter, because artificial intelligence could replace the doctor. We know what some program with many criticisms behind, but what is the message behind? That we have driverless car. And that's just, we are skeptical about that, because we could not trust that. We could not accept the role of Dr. Watson. But when we go in an Airbus 380, we have to know there are more robots in the Airbus 380 in a driverless car. That's very acceptable. I'm proud to be 380. And that's what is the challenge behind that. Automation will cover everything that is in routine. And so we are right to radiotherapy, because we have a lot of routine works in radiotherapy. We already have robots that offer us how to delineate the tumor, the critics organs, and they are there, very fast, very quick. We have only to do some correction. We have already a lot of robots. They are doing optimal radiation therapy treatment technology choice and dose delivery. And we accept them. We only overview that. So radiation therapy perspective, we have to train robots in our high-tech disciplines. We have to control robots. And then we have to offer much more structured knowledge dealing with big data, Alex already said it before, with combining many layers of knowledge to tailor modern radiotherapy. So that is the close future. Big companies are going to the market, to dealing with huge market like China, and that's their preparing washing machine, where four buttons will do a treatment with a control of a remote doctor. One doctor, 70 center, 70 million of people. So that is the what is behind the corner, already announced in radiation therapy. And then technology. In the between, that's there is the way to, that we have to deal with. That is new targeting way. We are really in a transition phase, no any longer combi in CT, so CT scan. We have MRI in our treatments room. And what we'll offer them? To capture some moment that we otherwise will never have possibility to see. And the machine will be old enough in the beam exactly when the prostate or other organ will go out. It's only technology, have it an impact in the day in the practice? We have some data, and I'm proud to show you them. This is our machine. At the end of the tunnel, patient can see their own tumor. They can see where they have to position in the tumor. And then they are really taking their own time to control his own breath. And then they will put the volume, the small volume or the larger volume of the tumor in a place where it will be impossible to be sure to target. Exactly in where we want to irradiate, it will take some second. And then when the tumor will be there, the treatment will start. What is produced as to this kind of approach that offer such a precise control driven by the patient that be fully active in doing his own treatment. That is the very first data we show in the ESTRO meeting, where you see these two curves diverge. Which kind of tumor? Pancreas. Where there were 23 treatments treated with this machine with a very high dose, unbelievable dose that we could not deliver outside this framework, where we were very, very precise. And the 19 patients that were treated with less dose. And you see the survival curves. This is obviously a generating idea study. But that shows us that it fit that could be a role for a very hypofractionated treatment that is with many in biological basis, one of the best choices for some very refractory tumors. And this curve fit with the other randomized trial that will be published recently. That is the story of our pancreatic cancer. And this is the verge. And this is the multi-center study that we are starting to manage in the centers that already have this technology in their hands. And the second technology that is booming now in the world that also will go with the same concept, high dose, very short volume, no surrounding organ damaged by this high tech, is proton therapy. And this is out with this, the scenario that in 5 years in Europe, this center will be distributed and available for the oncology community. And last but not least, you know that in the next 10 years, we have to position in radiotherapy in the scenario of immunotherapy. You know very well how radiotherapy exposes a lot of antigens. It works in facilitating the action of some inhibitors of not detecting cancer cell. And that is really what happens already 15, 20 years ago when we had to do radiochemotherapy for many tumors. And now the next 10 years we'll deal with this in combination of immunotherapy. So in conclusion, we know that we have a destiny. At the end, radiotherapy will not be any longer. And I hope that that will happen because we can cure cancer for our patients. We have to deal with knowledge management. That means to more and more automation in our daily practice. And as well in technology that we allow to give very safely high dose, unusual high dose, in a small volume, in the volume only of the small, for small means only tumor volume, that could change the story, namely if combined with a new understanding of what would be the environment that is around the tumor to be there. So just the final statement from Soren Kierkegaard, in that in a ship, when a captain is a cook, the sailor will hear from the speakers the menu of today, what is important today to eat, to have in the pocket. And never they will hear And never they will know what is the root of the way. And so such a session like this one, looking at what is the route that we have to follow, are very important, and they're very important that we do on a multidisciplinary basis. Thank you very much for your attention.